Hey folks, as a QA, it is important to understand what is a test environment. In this video, let's understand what is test environment. And test environment is a platform upon which a software is tested first. As I have mentioned, it is basically a platform upon which the software is tested initially. Once the software is ready, it will be tested in different stages of environment to stabilize the software. By finding the bugs, we can stabilize the environment, and getting the bugs fixed, we can stabilize more and more. And then we can send it to the production. Before deploying a module or a software or a piece of code, anything to the production, it must be tested at different levels. Then only it can be sent to the production, so that by performing these type of validation in the lower environments, it makes the customer and also us that confident that this software works perfectly fine. Even though it is not 100% defect free, but there is a confidence that all the major functionality, at least the happy path, is working fine. There are different types of environment that are there in real. So majorly a software will be tested in at least two different environments. Say is IT or system integration testing and UAT or user acceptance testing. So in real, these two are the environments that a tester will be testing. For example, suppose there is a code that has been deployed to SIT. Once after we give the sign off from SIT, then only the code will be getting moved to the next environment, that is the UAT, where all the user acceptance testing or the code will be tested in UAT. Basically, it is the code that will be accepted by the customer, and then only it will move to the production. Okay. And also adding to this, there is one another environment that usually developers test in, that is called dev environment. Once they make their changes, right, that will first get deployed to dev environment. First, they'll do their round of testing in dev environment. Then only it will be passed on to the QAs. An environment consists of all the setup required for testing, for example, database or the server, and also the UI looks with whatever the changes that has been made. The URL used to access test server usually looks almost similar to what we have in production, apart from the specification of the environment. Basically, most of the companies follow a similar kind of URL. For example, let's take an example of testing hacks. www.testinghacks.com. If this is the production URL, for us to test it, we can differentiate it with the environment name. For example, www.sit.testinghacks.com. So this significantly says that this is an SIT environment. And also, if suppose in case of UAT, that we can replace it with UAT. So that is how we can access the URLs. In real, this is a lot of companies follow this URL structure. Along with new feature, a bug also which needs to be tested is also deployed to this environment. So once after the bug is fixed, that also gets deployed to the environment so that you can test it and give the sign off. Once the QA gives sign off after testing in SIT and UAT, then only the feature or the new code will be moved to the production. So this is a major thing. Until and unless as a QA we give the sign off, it will not be moving to the production. Once we verify that everything is working fine and everything looks good, then only we are going to give the sign off. Otherwise we will raise a defect. And once after that defect gets fixed, that will also be deployed to the environment. So that again we will retest it and then we will give the closure. This is how it works. And also all these things will be performed upon an environment. That is why it is known as test environment. That's it for this video. If you like the video, please do like it and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.